And we're back. This time I'm going to show you one way how to create a shadow in Photoshop. I've got this original image once copied and I've excluded the shadow that was in it because I wanted to see how I would have recreated it. Let me copy it once, pressing Ctrl J, and then I'll select the gorilla in the image. That layer I've simply called cutout. You will find that image in the description below. So if you want to recreate this effect with the very exact same image, just click on it and download it for free. Just a basic cutout, that's fine. Click on layer mask and then copy the layer by pressing Ctrl J. I'll rename the lower one into shadow. And now I'll look at the angle of the sun to the gorilla and where the shadow should fall. Afterwards I'll apply the layer mask. So this layer only contains the gorilla itself. And then I hold Ctrl and I click on it to have a selection. I'll activate the brush tool, use a black color and I'll paint the selection black. Let me make the top layer invisible so you can see that. Press Ctrl D to deselect everything, then Ctrl T to transform. If you have a perfect composition, the sun would be on top of the gorilla and we could simply drag the shadow down. In this specific case, we need to adjust it manually a little bit more. Can always resize it, rotate it even more, and just press enter. And now we'll decrease the opacity. That looks fine, I would say. Then we give it a layer mask and we get rid of the edges with the brush tool and a black color to conceal parts of the shadow that we don't need. I'm going to speed this up a little bit, and I think that looks good. As I said, that is one way to create a shadow. There are various ways in Photoshop, but this is a simple one. It works best when you've got a sun on top of an object. But when you've got it with an angle like here, it's still very easily done. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.